Good afternoon, everybody. Just afternoon. My name is Dr. Linda Carrero. I'm the Associate Dean of Fine and Performing Arts in the Faculty of Humanities and the Director of the Marilyn I. Walker School of Fine and Performing Arts. At the Marilyn I. Walker School of Fine and Performing Arts, we acknowledge that we are situated on the traditional lands of the Anishinaabe, Haudenosaunee, and Attawatomi people. We acknowledge the immense harm done to First Nations, Métis, and Inuit communities throughout Turtle Island, and respect and affirm the treaty rights of all Indigenous peoples. We are committed to the ongoing processes of reconciliation and decolonization that result in meaningful work on this site. In recognition of a history that precedes us, we bring great care to the processes of creating, innovating, and expressing that we undertake at the school. In our commitment to moving beyond supremacy in all its forms, we honor the knowledge carriers, water protectors, the land and all living entities, past, present, and future, that impress upon this space. We also ask you to consider one thing you can actively do today to participate in making necessary change. You must be wondering why I'm standing here instead of Karin Di Bella, who most of you know as the face of Music at Noon, and that's because I'm sure you've noted that Karin is playing along with James Bourne, and they're featured on the stage today playing a piano duet. We're all really excited for that. I'm actually going to try and also channel Karin today and walk you through some of the few considerations that we ask you during the concert. So please, if you could just remember to turn off and silence your phones, as this is quite distracting. It's challenging for people who are on stage trying to play and focus, and also for others in the audience sitting beside trying to listen. We also ask no photos, videos, or recording of any kind. It is being live streamed and recorded already, so phones aren't needed. And because you're going to love this concert so much, you're going to want to replay it on the MIWSFPA YouTube channel. So happy Valentine's Day, and without further ado, Karin Di Bella and James Bourne.
Good afternoon, or good, yes, I guess it is afternoon, isn't it? Welcome, thank you for joining us today for this very special concert of music for piano four hands. And first of all, I'd just like to say that in the days before matchmaking sites like match.com and apps like Tinder and Grindr and all those other things, there was the piano duet in the 19th century. the best chance you had likely of getting to sit next to that pretty person you admired from down the street and under the watchful eye of a piano teacher with her ruler ready or to the wrap of your fingers if you brushed against one another. And we'll be beginning with one of the most beloved and important works for the piano duet repertoire, and that is the Fantasia by Franz Schubert. It was written in the last year of his life, and it's in four connected connected movements, so it's one of these longer forms that was moving from sonata form to these longer forms that were evolving throughout the 19th century. And so, yes, there won't be any spot for you to clap by mistake in the first piece, but we do hope you enjoy the Schubert Fantasy in F minor.
Thank you. I don't remember smiling so much on stage as I do when I play these with this guy. Jim and I go way back to undergrad days. So I won't tell you how long ago that was. It was like 5 years ago. Hey, Jim. Thank you for the polite chuckles. Okay. So Samuel Barber, this is a whole different piano duet universe, a whole different harmonic language. And Barber falls into that category of composers that likes to write in what we call sort of added note or wrong note harmonies, which is a great disclaimer because you won't know which ones are actually wrong and which ones are intended to sound that way. So gives us a little wiggle room. So like in the Schubert, the harmonies are pretty straightforward. You know, he does some funny things moving from keys to keys. But in Barber, the harmonies, they kind of sound straightforward, but there's these extra crunchy bits in them, and that makes it really fun. So the set of pieces is called Souvenirs, and Barber wrote it for piano four hands. He later orchestrated it for a ballet. And there are six pieces in the set. We are playing four of them. There are three in your program. We've added the sixth movement, the gallop, at the end. So we will go in order as that your program has listed, but we're adding the last one. So there's a fourth one at the end. And what's really fun with all the dances in this set is he does a little bit of a quirky twist on all of them. And I was telling Chloe, our stage manager backstage, that this, the third movement, the pas de deux in this set, was the whole reason I wanted to play this program on this day. So when you're attending a ballet and you see the pas de deux is the big duet that features the male and female leads, and the choreography is set up for them to work as a unit. They don't have separate choreography that they do at the same time. They perform together as a unit. And in this pas de deux, you'll probably notice that in the Schubert, when we were set up, you know, Jim was here and I was here, and our inner hands sort of are on top of each other, like very, very little. But in the Barber, our inner arms are actually in each other's space all the time. And in the pas de deux, you'll see that evolve as the piece goes on. So it's kind of part of the reason we wanted to set it up a little differently. And I know the live stream is enjoying some great camera shots too, courtesy of Rob in the booth. Thanks, Rob. So keep an eye out for that. It's a really different duet approach. It's very interactive between the two musicians. Oh, give me the score. And I wanted to leave you with a little something that the composer wrote himself. In 1952, this is Barber, not me. In 1952, I was writing some duets for one piano to play with a friend. And Lincoln Kirstein suggested that I orchestrate them for a ballet. Commissioned by Ballet Society, the suite consists of a waltz, schottische, which we're not doing, pas de deux, two-step, also not doing, hesitation tango, and gallop. One might imagine a divertissement in a setting reminiscent of the Palm Court of the Hotel Plaza in New York, the year about 1914, epoch of the first tangos. Souvenirs, remembered with affection, not in irony or with tongue in the cheek, but in amused tenderness.